Of course, we must continue so many challenges, but in the end, we will win. The king will say, Mama, no go sleep, no go sleep. Back to where we are. Our people must understand the need why information must be passed to the next generation. Because without this vital information, anybody will come out and treat us anyhow. A people without a root, as our leader said, it's like a tree that does not have tap root. Every wind of doctrine will blow them away. That is our problem. Now, for you to understand a little bit, why is it that there is no state in Yoruba land that is named English name? Oh, Yoruba can't speak English. It's all right. Why is it that there is no state in the northern part of Nigeria that does not that have English name? Oh, Hausa don't know how to speak English, Abi. Fulani don't know how to speak English. Only in Biafra land. And to us, we think it's advancement. I'm from Delta State. Delta Bonyebe. Ask yourself, that Delta, where the heck, where does it come from? Those of us who manage to have original name, even the name is a concocted jargon. When you hear somebody say, I'm a Bayasarian, is Bayasa Ijaw language? Is Bayasa Mbiama language? Utweke language? Patani language? Bayasa mean nothing to any Bayasa man. Because they just pick initial of all the community within that Bayasa. Your name be, you are Ogodogodo, you are Ogodogodo. They now say A plus B plus C plus C. They now concocted it. It was longer than Bayasa. When Abua did not play to the gallery for Nigeria, they lived the IUL in Bayasa and leave the people in River State. So their own initial was removed from the name Bayasa. That is how it become Bayasa. Today, if you don't tell your children, they will think Bayasa means something. As if Fulani are trying to take over Bayasa, one Fulani will come and give you the meaning of Bayasa. Inside Hausa, already they are telling you that Oyel and Bayasa belong to Jigawa. And the name they give to you is nonsense. It doesn't have meaning. And so when they debate with your children, in the nearest future, if Biafra is not restored, your children will run away. Because after all, it doesn't mean. Imagine if where I come from is called Sokoto. Tell me why Sokoto will not come, Fulani Sokoto will not come and take over. Now you see why all these things you must teach your children. They are evil. But we are to be held responsible because we don't tell ourselves the children. And I see people who I would have fought because you see them defending the name of their state vigorously. How can you call us Iguacha? Eh? We are not Iguacha, we are Porakot. We are Porakot. Who the heck is Porakot? Go and look at the history of that criminal, Porakot. You should be ashamed when you are telling them you are from Porakot. You are from any state where they have changed the name, concocted fake name and give you. Tell them the name of your community if they have not changed it. We are to be blamed. You must tell your children the truth. Yoruba have deep hatred for you as a Biafran. Not because it's in them. Now, let's look at it at the other way. Racism, we are not born with racism, but we are taught racism. Yorubas are not born with hatred for Biafrans, but they are taught to hate Biafra. It's good for them. It's working for them. 10%. It's coming to them. But we, what are we teaching our children? Oh, enjoy life. Life is good. Don't mind them. Don't look for problem. Enjoy life. You know, Irina, we are jumping up and down. You know, fine boy. We got to live the life. Life no long. You got to live the life. Is this life? There is ongoing news on social media. They said a Fulani cow entered one sacred land in Yoruba land, and the gods of Yoruba now destroy the cow. Is it 30 cow? Now, Yoruba want you to know that their gods is powerful. But Yoruba pastor are destroying our shrine. And one holier than I will come and say, hey, are you telling us to worship idol? If I see India runner, somebody say, and I'm adding them model. But you check it now, Yoruba now, with all their pastor, they are telling you now that their god of thunder killed Fulani cow. Where is Amadioha now? But you will not understand. You think our fathers are stupid? Tell me, what value have we added to our culture outside what our father left for us? Okay, Indomie. We now know how to cook Indomie. We know how to do Ashebi. What other food? You are now drinking Kunu everywhere. Very soon now they will bring us Burukutu. And if care is not taken, you need to Shinama, Shimelu. Not be my outside they eat. Today now, look at our market. When you go buy pepper, you go see Cameroon pepper, China pepper, Indian pepper, Ghana pepper. Every pepper of the pepperistic pepper. We don't even know our own pepper again. Look at Fulani. They are okay with their food. Two and Shinama, two and Shimelu, two and Shokoko. It's their food. It's okay for them. Don't you know that no Yibo man can eat apu steady for 1 week and remain normal? Their life will never be the same again. There is nothing they will do about it. Bring one of your Yibo friends to the village. Give them apu, one tablet, three times a day. After 1 week, you will see their life can never remain the same again. The same way you give your children indomie, macaroni, spaghetti. Their life can never remain the same again. Teach your children the truth. We have wandered away greatly. But we think it doesn't matter. It matters. Yoruba today can congregate around themselves within 1 minute and deal with me and you. Look at how many years now. IPOB have been battling for you to wake up. Some people are even very proud. We have been in IPOB since 2014. No, you are in IPOB since 1914. You are very proud of it. Maybe we'll be saying we have been fighting for this struggle since 70 years. Let's do what we want to do and get out of this place. Some people, even the more Biafran delay, they are very happy. But you don't know what is at stake. Look at us without communicating, without saying a word. The Fulani, look at what they are doing with us. Because they respect their distance. I told you that they are Shango. They are Oshunde killed cow. He killed cow, 40 cow. But it's a direct message that carried snuff. Go pour for Fulani. Fulani cow eats snuff, finish that. The land is sacred. It is no sacred. It is Gudiga. This god is angry. He don't want them to desecrate them. Now he now kill Nama. Why did he not kill the Abuki? Where are the dead body of Abuki? Ndiara, you are fooling us, all right? But it's good for you. Go ahead with it. When we tell you to look for snuff, all those pieces of land, all these Indian sheep bring their cow to. You pour snuff there, let them look at themselves there. But of course, we don't know most of these things. We don't know them. We won't tell you here. But it is good. We pass the real information to the next generation. When we come out here, we talk about our father, who withstand the world. When the war descended on this tiny Biafra, they stood their ground for 3 years. You think they use Robo to hold this land? When they tell you how they overcome, you will be shocked. But what am I saying? We don't even know the road to our community. If care is not taken, some of us, when you come to your village, you don't know the road. You don't know where to enter from. You don't know anything again. Because nobody is teaching you. Nobody. There are certain things, knowledge about our people that cannot be missing. Now let's go deeper. Or not everybody will understand, but those who will understand will understand. Now let's look at the river. In Abo, we have so many rivers, but people don't know. The rivers are named after the owner of the land. For those who are in Abo, they may not know all these things because erosion has killed most of this river. We used to go to one river we call Iyi Mary George, husband and wife. The man is George, the woman is Mary. They own that land. And so the river that falls in that portion becomes their land. It's not because Mary George is Oyibo. We have Iyi Akon, we have Iyi Ekpe. I can begin to mention them. Ozenuwebu. Now, all these river have what they forbid. The one they call Ozenuwebu. It, as deep as it is, it's more than 50 feet deep. That is the shallow area of it. But if you throw needle there, you will see it. The water is so clean like crystal. You go through Awuchi Road, you will see that river there. And so we have to trek, or rather drive, for more than 5 kilometers to get to that river, to get drinking water in those days. You can imagine a depth of 50 feet. If you throw needle, you will still see the needle inside that water. But they have strange things. Go to Uromi Junction. That river there, they call Iyakun and Iyekme. The one by the right, if you are coming from Lagos, that is the one that people can go. Enter the other one by the left. The same river, on the right, it is white. On the black, on the left, it is black. Some strangers don't enter there. Some indigenous don't enter there. They represent something in our community. And when you get there, your land speaks. They expect you to do certain things, but you don't know. You don't know. There are plants that represent a lot of things, but you don't know. I do not know the name of all these plants in English. I would begin to mention this name. And you will see what some of these flowers, one of them is sold for, as small as it is, like 150. It's sold for 50,000 naira. They have so many things they do. There are flowers they call masquerade tree. There are works they do. But you will not know. To some, you are designing it. There are a lot of things our father knew. They kept it for us. But the few people who know it now, they will only tell you when they want to use it to exploit you. Pass this information to the next generation. Do you think that place, Yoruba King Fulani cow, do you think Fulani will go there again? Let them go now. Or let them build barrack there. The gods is waiting for them. Where is our own gods? Chibuike Amechi want to give Igboche land to Buhari. And the Igboche people say, our gods, we have to consult our gods. That is that in Kule Adamu Farouk they were talking. We want their land. They say the gods say no. You know, you see the power of the gods. Adi Amama. You are destroying your gods. And they are using their own gods to destroy you. Adamu Farouk and Kule, they said it. When you want to need their land, they will tell you that the gods is angry. But now Yoruba gods have started killing cow. But Yoruba pastor have destroyed the shrine of our own gods. So will our own gods kill cow now? So cow will have to kill us. There are little information about our place, about our culture, about our tradition, about us as a people. Tell your children this truth. You go to 9VG every day, 9VG, 9VG. You are praying against ancestral curse. Every ancestral curse, every ancestral curse. On ancestral, no get blessing. On ancestors, no get blessing. Which year are we going to begin to pray for ancestral blessing? Only ancestral curse, every ancestral curse, every ancestral curse. No, look what Jesus, Chineke, make one on we Billy. May God have mercy upon us. But without all these things being put in place, we are going to fall. We are going to fall. There is more about us than any of you can imagine. There is more to us than your heart can comprehend. But then, we must know this truth. That is why the Bible says, my people perish because they lack knowledge. You don't know who you, the meaning of, most people don't even know the meaning of the name they bear. Uyibo can answer stone, snake. It's okay for them. They know the meaning. Most of us don't know the meaning of the name they bear. I will stop there. If you are a father, you are keeping secret for your children. Well, may God have mercy on you. You are a mother. Now, let me say something before we go. There are few evidence that will show you that Biafra is Biafra, irrespective of where they are today. How did Ikwere woman know how to cook egusi soup? And some woman from Urobo cook egusi soup? Then you go to Cross River State, they are cooking egusi soup. You go to Enugu, go to Abo, everywhere Biafrans are, they cook egusi soup, they cook okra soup. Most of these people have not seen themselves in their lifetime. Who teach them? You can call it Banga or Ofako. Go to Robo, you will see the Ofako. You see the original Banga. Who taught them? This will show you that all of us are coming from the same kitchen. But Yoruba have only three soup. Or do I give them four? You have a wedu, you have a four. Then you have pepper soup. Which soup do they have again? Do we cook a wedu? Do we cook a four? If the pepper one Yoruba woman will eat, if 10 Biafran women eat them, they will be taken to India for treatment. But it's in their DNA. Do we eat it to Anshinama, to Aoshikapa? You know, you begin to see. Our mothers did not come from the same kitchen. Who taught your mother how to tie two wrapper? Who taught them? Now you begin to see what you are saying. Stop hiding the truth from your people. Stop hiding it. As we speak, there are people who are still alive, who know the history and the truths, circumstances surrounding us, but they won't tell us. They are keeping quiet. Leave it. My son, don't talk about it. It's okay. The miracle will come. You go to Yoruba church. No. Pass this information to the next generation. Pass it to them. Pass it to them. It will do us good. I'll be back in a minute.
Mr. Floro, I'm doing it.
Mock on the
I can see my people in rivers. I also see my people in the town. West River and Akwa Ibom. Even when in Edo State, I can see my people in Enugu. I can see my people in Anambra. I also see my people.
We are one family, the same DNA. We are traceable because there are men and women who stood to tell us this truth. After the war, many of our parents, they have billions that they didn't take to the bank, but they hid the money. Some of them are on top of palm tree. Some of my people, they climb on top of palm tree, tie their money there, some inside ceiling, some dug the ground and buried it. Most of them died of sickness and disease that their money would have saved them. Today, one day you gamble to renovate your roof, you see a bunch of money. They are useless, at least at the moment. But if they have confided in one of their son, it will not be like that. Don't think your children are evil. It's the way you handle them. You make your children think money is anything. They will value money more than life. There is something my father used to do in those days. They will bring out my money, or maybe up to 200,000. That time, the highest denomination of zoo currency is 20 naira. So you should know this, the volume of 200,000. It can be up to 40 carton, Crest biscuit carton. They will say, start counting it. They know I can't count. But when I grew up, I know why they do those things. It's so that person money no go enter my eye. These are messages they are teaching us. If you have children you can trust, you will not hide your money for them. Today, all those money are gone. There are a lot of informations we can give to our children, but not on this radio. But start doing the right thing. So in the end, Biafra must be restored. Our line is temporarily open. You can call in and make your own contribution. Tell our people what they need to know. Advantages and disadvantages is going to help them. Our WhatsApp line remains 070-815-45642. 070-815-45642. And our direct line is 081-221-52971. Our direct line once again is 081-221-52971. And special number for the female is 081-288-58614. Special number for the female once again is 081-288-58614. Caller on the line, can you hear me? Yes, good evening from here. Go ahead, please.
Yes. Good evening. My name is Inyobon Gabriel. I'm calling from Ibocha.
Inyobon, my bad, yeah.
Idioko, Mazi, I line the busy where we are trying number. So, I will call it like 300, 400 miss call. Mazi, this topic we bring today, now, we are telling my people, say, if our forefather, we don't do God bad things, say, God for wipe our forefather out. Like, we go wipe someone and Gomorrah and the rest of Babylon. They be say our forefather we do God bad things for no conscience today. That thing, you know, say for my place, for where we are from. If we don't do any traditional something, they will carry cook kai kai, that maybe internal original cook one. They will put that for short. They will carry for up. Say God will there for heaven and God will there for ground for earth here. They will soak finish. They will put the kai kai for ground. Then that thing where they won't carry out. The thing go work instant. Mazi. I challenge people. You get one to return with cassava. No beer tuber for my place. If you approve cassava, you will see small tuber of cassava. They come and consult the God. The God say one day the God gonna give date. They call out for our place, available. Now Mackenzie Day. They say the God say make you cook fufu apple. Go for the market, make all our village people come gather for that market, eat that food there, then leave the remaining to the farms and their commons. Mazi, you know, believe what you happen, no? After they eat that, those things, then leave and their commons. You know, when time for harvest comes, the harvest cassava. Mazi, we see 2 bags of cassava, you just operate only 1 cent of cassava, you get 2 bags of cassava, we go do, we go reach, we go full 100 kg bag. Mazi, this topic we bring today, hey, may God keep you alive. Keep my leader Mazinandi alive. Keep Uche before and everybody where they struggle to bring this thing to come to reality. Mazi, I don't get too much credit, I beg. Make a Boron Young song. Bless and guide every all of us in the mighty name of Aburo Young song. In true.
You see, thank you. Our people must understand. Like our brother has said now, he said, there were times their cassava was not doing well. They consult the gods. But I don't want you to limit it to that place. One of my friends in America, we were discussing, and he said to me, that, do you know my children don't know that goats are born? They thought they plant goats in the lab. They thought goat is a plant. His children, mature children. He said, I have to tell you the truth. My children think they plant goat. So they go and harvest goat. Because they see all of them in the poultry, in the lab. But today, many people don't even know how to rear fowl. Why wouldn't they be using cow, lugaring us everywhere? Many people cannot even train goat. Many things are gone. For instance, cassava. There is a cassava that they eat like yam. They don't use it to do akpu. Moments of you don't know. If you see them, you don't know them. It's not every cassava you use to do akpu or gare. There is a special, another species of cassava. They use it to eat like yam. You just harvest the cassava. You cut it like porridge, yam. Most of you don't know. So many things. Nobody is telling anybody. And some of us become too advanced. Once you now do a white collar job, you call the village life outdated, backwardness. One day you see what you will do for us. Look at Fulanis who are sleeping inside gutter. As we are talking now, the Fulanis anywhere in Biafra, they are in one uncompleted building, one motor park, or they are in the a duplex you build for them. But they don't have sense. But these people who don't have sense now, they are the one taking over our land, deceiving the whole world. Call on the line your name and where are you calling from?
Hello, good evening, sir.
Good evening. Go ahead, please.
Yes, my name is Chukwu Deoparadi and I'm calling you from Igbota. Mazi, I so much like what you are bringing up these days. Because our people are forgotten who we are, where we are coming from. And that is a problem. We are looking for our freedom. And many people don't understand what we are doing. But I know that the God that brought our leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, to take us to that promised land, must surely finish his work. And we will enjoy it. I am an IPOB member in Igbota.
Thank you very much. We must continue. Are you there, caller on WhatsApp? Caller on WhatsApp, are you there?
Yes.
Caller on WhatsApp, are you there? Of course, the zoo epileptic people are unbearable these days. But we must continue. Caller on the line, are you there?
Hello, good evening, sir.
This is female line. I'm sorry, I cannot take the call. Call on WhatsApp, are you there?
Welcome.
Call on WhatsApp.
Hello, sir.
Go ahead, please.
Hello?
Go ahead, please. Stop listening to your radio or I will.
Okay, sir. Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Master George, I've been calling you. Yes, sir. I've been calling you. I've been sending message on this WhatsApp line. So all this while, I've been trying to see if I can get any IPO family member around here since I located down to Aba. And since then, nobody has been able to give me vital information.
Don't worry, you send me your number and phone number. I mean, your name, your phone number. Am I correct?
Yes.
Don't worry, it has been forwarded to those who will respond to you. Hopefully, I don't know what is delaying them, but I know they are listening. They shall respond to you.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much.
If you notice, when I have forwarded your information, I will always indicate that I came to your work.
Yes.
So once you see my response, whether I talk to you or I don't talk to you, once I respond on your work, know your message has been delivered.
Okay, sir.
So
okay,
they
sir.
Shall
Thank
contact you.
You.
Thank you very much.
Okay, sir. Thank you. God bless you, sir.
And you too. We must continue.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Our people must get ready. We must tell ourselves the history. Pass this information to the next generation. Are you there, caller on the line? Caller on the line, are you there?
Hey, hello, sir.
Good evening from here. Go ahead, please.
I feel like I hear you today, man. I've been trying this number, too. You know, get your... I agree to the good work you are doing for us. So my God bless me.
Thank God, my
Land
God.
Land the company for me, just a native official like I go with the province.
Thank you very much.
You can try and try every day to reach you, man. I did you speak to you before, but you try the line, I'm telling you, I try to get you, I need to get you.
It is well.
Yeah, well, I'm very happy, man. You can't, man. Even if I'm you are going to have another line itself. Like you know, that like that you didn't use. So I just say,
thank you, my brother. We must continue. Caller on the line, your name and where are you calling from?
Good evening, sir.
Good evening, Agwani. Go ahead, please. Ada, go ahead.
I think I can make you go to Gabia, my new junior. Ikabununu. Onye naanị ya bụ Chineke nke kere igwe na ala. Ọnyanwa ga-eduru anyị n'obodo ahụ e kwere na nkwa. Hello, sir.
Yes, the world is listening.
A sị na Chineke onye kere igwe na ala, ọnyanwa ga-eduru anyị na ala ahụ e kwere na nkwa. Ọ masịkwa ndị ezi ụha na-eme Jehova aha gị mere onwe ya aha.
Ise.
Ise.
Ise. Thank you very much. Mbano. How can he be
doing?
How can he be
doing? Abachos,
I go man. Thank you very much. We must continue. Call on WhatsApp. Call on WhatsApp. Are you there?
Good evening.
Good evening from here.
Yes, I'm here. I'm here. Good evening, my African rep.
Good evening, my brother. Go ahead, please.
In Biafra land. Regarding what tonight's program is about, and one of our brother that called from Port Harcourt, what he said about their farm and everything. I have something I could say. Hello?
Go ahead, please. The world is listening.
Okay. Yeah. I have something I could give as a testimony in a way. In my village where I'm from, there used to be this man called Abeji. He's a traditional man. He's one of the people that keeps our tradition. Does Omenala whilst a lot of people were doing church and all of those stuff. So what I'm saying is this, that this man lived more than 100 years since that man died up to today, to be honest with you. I've never heard of anybody that lived up to that year, his age. What everybody keeps saying is, which time I call, I'll hear, oh, Mr. Okeke is sick, or Mr. Crawford is in the hospital. This one is happening, the other one is happening. But that man called Abeji, who does traditional our traditional practice and everything, he lived longer than most of us that are alive today. So that taught me something, that we really need to go back to our sickness, traditional.
The sickness that kill people now, the name of the sickness is gone too soon, or after it brief, to, after a brief illness. Everybody, exactly. Just look at their burying handbill or poster. He said that gone too soon,
yeah,
or after a brief illness. That is the only sickness, yeah, that kill our people.
All, yeah, we need to go back. We need to go back to our traditional way of life, the way our ancestors used to live. You know, worship to cook in truth and in honesty. You know, to live longer life. This is what I really have to say. You know, regarding what that our brother said from Port Harcourt, that is true. It does not only affect our life, it affects our, even in every way of our life, our farming, our everything. I don't know where to start. Everything that we do as a people, it affects us. It affects us in every way. If we don't go back to our original way of life, we will keep suffering, going in circle, year after year, generation after generation. We have to go back to our ancestors, where, how they used to live their life before. If we want to live longer life and inherit what God has have given to us in our Biafra land. So that's just the little I have to say for now, and I really thank you for what you're doing. You're doing a great job for us. Chukwu Okeabema will keep you alive. You will live to enter Biafra. You will see Biafra. You're doing a great job.
Thank you. Chukwu
Okeabema will be with you and bless you.
Thank you.
All hail Biafra.
All hail Biafra. Our people must remember
Look at the Yoruba gods. Yoruba gods is killing Hausa Fulani. Come out and tell me that our Fulani will still go to sacred Yoruba land. There are two things for you to learn. You are in Nigeria. Yoruba gods have killed 3 Fulani cow. I hope DSS will go for them. But where is our own gods? Yoruba pastors has destroyed our own gods. By now, our gods, if our own gods is killing your Fulani cow, do you tell me they will still want Ruga? Shebi, now you see. It's simple. Yoruba gods killed 30 or is it 300 Fulani cow? Because the land is sacred. The cow entered there, put shit there. The gods got angry and killed the cow. But this Yoruba who left their own gods are the one destroying our gods. Now, where is our gods? Where is Ekpentu? Where is Idigun? Akiemoho? Amadioha? Where are all of them? Yoruba church have destroyed them. So who will chase away Ruga for us? When they tell on, and I know they understand, I just they show sense. Everybody they show sense. These little things you think it really don't matter. One day you will discover that they are the pillar that holds our life. And may it never be too late for us at that time. We don't misquote what we are saying. If you like, learn. You are able to discern the truth. Embrace it. If you like, they speak grammar. I am assuring you, every Fulani in that land of Yoruba, where the gods kill cow, they will be on their heels by now. There are no good sense. By now, also, you want the gods to kill you. Can DSS arrest the gods? Can Nigeria Army go and arrest the gods? When we tell you to wake up our gods, so he can be treating all this info. Some people are letting Yoruba to destroy our gods. Let Nigeria, let Brutai go and arrest that ghost now. Are you there, caller on the line?
Hello, George Onyebe, good evening.
Good evening from here. Go ahead, please.
Mr. Pickett, now from Willam, do you know the reason why I called now? I attended Bible school. And there was a Yoruba man, Ogapana school, and I don't want to mention the school. So the man said that the pastors from Yoruba land, they cannot do without their gods. They cannot do their gods and their back. That's why I made a church within 6 months or 1 year. Church are secluded everywhere. The people don't know. I don't deceive Garendi Kanye here. I love this topic too much. That's why I call you. And today is my first time. May God bless you.
And thank you very much.
You're a wonderful man.
God is faithful.
Thank you.
Thank you. We must continue. Our people must not make any mistake about that. Tell your children this truth. They are scary truth. Honestly, it's not palatable. It's not sweet. But tell them this truth. Tell them the truth. Today, I see people spending their energy. We Biafrans. He say, that my brother is evil. We will kill him. You will burn them tire. You will destroy them. Let me tell you, there is nothing you will do about it. I love Oyibo, the way they encode secret. They don't let us know. But we are looking at that thing. Abrakata mi brakata. The more you look, the less you see. There is something known as 101. It could be fashion. It could be gene. It could be anything. But it passes a direct message. 101 simply means that in every 100, one must be abnormal. In mathematics, it's called probability. Probability in the sense that every 100 car that is produced, there is every probability that one will have factory error. In every family of 3, there must be one madman. That is why they say out of every 12, there must be Judas. We are killing our Judas. We don't need to kill them. Go and learn from history. Adamu Farouk, they know this truth. I will say, if I see any Hausa man killing another Nigerian man, I will never call them evil. Let me tell you, you see all those, your brother or your sister, who have stubborn, so stubborn, they are the reason why nobody can come to your family and misbehave. Go for village center, watch them. Some people go say, hey, make we go fight that family. He say, which family they talk? Chukuma them family. My hand is no deal. My hand is no deal. Because they know say Chukuma madness in no girl level. So they're not wrong because then they fear you where they speak BB grammar. They're not saying madman, they wait for them. And this madman on a go kill him. That is when they say, Wedike, you don't stop them. You manage them. They are weapon. I have witnessed many protests. One of them, let me share this evening. Maybe you'll be able to get where I'm coming from and where we are going to. We were discussing how to organize that protest, that rally. And then we say, where do we start from? How do we move? And everybody say what you want to say. Gentlemen, men of God say, women of God say, educated, intellectual, academic, everybody finish saying. And then somebody stood up and said, oh God, no worry. Now we go start. When I buy Igbo, when I buy Igbo, finish. When I just give me money, make I buy Igbo, make when I leave every other thing for me. And then gentlemen stand up and say, no, we don't want Igbo here. No, don't say Igbo. Keep quiet. Those of you in Port Harcourt, we know who I'm talking about. Because I was in port there. That was the guy that is climbing high tension to tie our flag on high tension. When army people nearly die for electric, say then they go remove them. You just say that use ordinary eye, they climb high tension, tie Biafra flag. You take enough Igbo. But you are busy killing people smoking Igbo. But Igbo smoke Igbo. They can call it Guaruana or Juagualua. They speak Igbo, but you are killing your people on Angu Goose, on Angu Goose. You don't know, say if we're not getting the Angu Goose, we're not going to go for rally. You go use ordinary eye, they look Nigerian Taramador army. And now you know. So when your brother is bad, manage them. Manage them. They are there for the purpose. Jesus knew that Judas was a Satan. He managed him. Without Judas, who would have sold him? If he was not sold, would he have died for your sin? If you like, understand. If you know, like, they teach your children another culture. You know, abandon your own. You are very wise, advanced. In our super key. Go ahead. One day you will see that these are what holds our foundation as a people. Why do you think all this nonsense is happening to us as a people? You see people argue blindly. God. We must continue. Call on the line. Can you hear me? Call on the line. Are you there?
Okay, mother. I'm gonna make a leg in Ambeda.
Good evening. Good
evening. There was one of the other in Amma. Neke, Nori, Nafo, Nankwo. I thank Chukwu Abiyama for this very topic of today. You are just like we are living together. Because every bit secret of life I do tell my children. The mistake some of our parents did, they do wait for the time their children will come to the age of accountability. Then along the line, they will drop dead. Then they die with that secret without telling their children who they are. They will die with that secret without telling their children the way forward. But I thank God that I start my own children with their life history. It sounds so stupid in the eyes of every other person around me, but I know that I'm passing information. My little baby of 5 years went to school. And when they gave them assignment, they said, are you a Nigerian or not? He said, mommy, I did not put that answer because I'm not a Nigerian. They asked us to do our national item. I tell them I am not a Nigerian. My auntie flogged me. That is the information we need to pass to our children. If a little girl of 5 years could develop such hatred to this evil identity, this evil contraction called Nigerian, you should imagine what will come in the next 10 years. Bakassi men are using the force that they have. In fact, our people know go learn something on time. My Lord, our people know go learn something on time. These very Bakassa people, now then, early this year, they carry Fulani herdsmen in the name of Nigerian uniform, in the name of SARS, carry them work at the whole area where our people, our boys, they take their arrest them, say na Igbo smokers, say na court boys. At the end, Nigerian so-called useless contraction tells them to drop their weapon. Now, imagine they are so stupid to an extent that they have started carrying this very Operation Python dance they thought by going in every corner to pick our voice again. When will these fools learn from their mistakes? That one by the side. There is a particular place in Obubura when a particular time came when Kasava became so angry and jealous that him as a cassava do produce food for everybody, but they honor yam. Why is it that they do New Yam Festival, they cannot do cassava festival? That very year, there was hunger on the village. There is hunger in the town. Until the people that knows the meat, that knows how to do the needful, has to enter and do the needful. Cassava became back again as cassava to feed our people. As I am talking to you, I am not a Christian, sorry to say this. If any pastor tell me that him as a pastor know how Jesus Christ was being born, let him challenge me. The same man who pregnanted Elizabeth is the same man who pregnanted Mary in the synagogue. As I'm talking to you, the fools that are calling themselves Jesus, Jesus, their savior, are all lost people. Now we go back to Yoruba. Yoruba men are all Ogboni and awkward men. They can never be Christians. They are only using Bible to decorate because they know that it's only Bible that they can use to wash the brains of their friends. But secretly, they are doing sacrifice. The Yoruba pastors have been using the blood of our people, doing sacrifice in their altars in order to appease the Ogboni and the other court that they belong to, but our people fail to understand. Do you know that a particular girl went to serve a particular pastor food because they share it week by week, week by week? That day he entered into this very Biafran child who came from Iguacha to go and serve a particular pastor food. When she got to that place below, the pastor was naked. Oh my God, what happened? The pastor shut the door. And she was shouting, Jesus Christ. The pastor said, shh, this is not the time of Jesus Christ. Kneel down here. And this pastor messed with our girl. Okay, if this pastor raped this girl, it would have been 100 times better. But this pastor asked this girl to feed her mouth through his manhood. That is how they have been using to progress themselves. That is why their churches do grow day by day, because their gods, their evil gods, knows how to take the sacrifice of innocent people and those ones who don't have sense. I am not a church person and can never be. For the past 5 years,
thank
have
you.
Ended. Mechuku Abiyama bless you. Protect you, preserve you. Mechuku Kiki Abiyama's name.
You see. Our people must remain focused. Tonight, I warn you about Yoruba Church. I don't hide my mouth about it. Vicky Emmanuel, you said something and say, can we please use wisdom? Honestly, I share your sentiment. I understand what you mean. So Nigeria, we say, oh, IPOB, they smoke Ibu. But you think those senators who carry the moss in the National Assembly and jump fence, you think they drink anointing oil? No, all those senators who are fighting like Agbelu, you know, Oshodioke and Oju Eleba, do you think they drink a Fanta? Make we know they deceive ourselves. We they wait for Nigeria. You don't know Buhari smoke goof before he die? You don't see Obasanjo thick lips. Say they use hanky and methylator rub the pan, we make and the red. Waiting be this senator where they dance, Dilo Menai. You think all those in dance and all those in Aluta Continua. You think say na Fanta then they drink, they shout Aluta Continua. You don't see who they Panwine Club, where be Kega Boy, where no they drink Panwine. Make we no deceive ourselves. We go tell you the truth. If you like here, your senator then go smoke Igbo. Sorry. Nigerian senator go smoke Igbo finish. Come there, they talk, say, the reason why Fulani herdsmen, they kill Biafrans. We say the road where cow they follow for olden days. Say they don't grade them now. No road for cow to follow again. So they go kill us. You think say no be more than smoke, they talk that nonsense. Make we use our brain, oh. Now George only be the talker. And I'm responsible for what happened here. No matter how bitter or naked that truth is, you must receive it. Look at your senator, Nigerian senator. Take Igbo finish because they will come and they mesmerize. Who is deceiving who? And then they keep people say they smoke Igbo. But the lawmakers in Nigeria, all of them are goof. Indian hand smoker. Look their lips. Look Jubri lips self. As in lips be like three months baby lips. Look Jubri lips. That is the handwork of Igbo. When I don't let them deceive you now. They call it lion food. Near water. If say my brain carry on. When I add on to this one where I carry, and I go no. Mad people. Tell me who don't smoke Igbo, all those your pastor and all of them. The amazing thing is that if you want to see Igbo in manifestation, look at the session of National Assembly during procession. You will be amazed. A normal lawmaker carrying the mosque and jumping fence, carrying chair and be hitting themselves. What can do that miracle? If not that Nigerian senator smoke Igbo. Mad people. You come out and they say we are going to try you by Sharia law and bring masquerade to testify against you in the court. Who can do that if it's not Igbo? Focus on what I want you to learn and leave what they think or what they say. All we they have been thinking and saying, where has it led us to? We've lived all our life trying to appease people. Politics of appeasement. Oh, let's not provoke Yoruba. Let's not provoke Hausa. They keep deceiving us year after year. Second Niger Bridge. Ogoni clean up. So resource control. Youth empowerment. Empowerment youth. Is it not only Igbo smoker that come up every year to promise you second Niger Bridge? Are they not drunks? I will stop this segment there. If you like, they lie to your children. It's your business. If you like, call them and tell them. Train them. Tell them the truth. But teach them the right path. Don't forget, you won't walk that path with them. It is your duty to point the right direction to them, for them. There is a difference between knowing the path and walking the path. That is why there is a difference between somebody who go to Yoruba City, or is it university, and somebody who go to Polytechnic. That is why you have so many Nigerians who can speak grammar. When they start speaking here, there is one Edo senator. I don't know where he represents. When he starts speaking English, I know Igbo will go and rethink. As we are pluralizing and the policies, and so we now mechanize and who do they speak all this grammar for? Do you say an ordinary idea use they speak all those grammar? But tell them to come and practice, put what they are speaking in place. They can't. That is why if you see them for inside Yoruba television, China television, BBC, CNN, other 419 television, wear better suit, not tie. You think they're better people, they talk. Common sense, they don't have no brain. So when you see them for television, see your Jubri for UN. They who know whether an Arabic they speak. Nonsense. And we are obliged to reach. You see some hopeless Yoruba, we forge certificate. Prove that now, you see what revelation will come out there. Dress properly, very well. Sit in front of television. Be lying to through their anus. Hold their mouth, then begin use Nyash talk. And you appreciate them. We won't talk. So they now, we say that we will not die. But yet they are killing us. See, I know what is causing all these things. And that is because we are peaceful. But as far as the leadership of IPOB say, we must remain peaceful. We must remain peaceful. Yoruba church goer, go and give thanks even because of the man of God that lead us. If not, I'll be back in a minute. Yes, Sincere apology, I kept you waiting on the line for so long. My brother on WhatsApp, go ahead, please.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
My name is Mother Abuchi. My name is Mother Abuchi. I'm calling from Dakar, Senegal. I'm so happy with the topic you have brought this evening. Because our people need to go back to our roots. That is the main problem we are having in this at this age. Because our generation, our forefathers left something good for us. But those that will come after us, they have spoiled everything. Like issue of this mortuary. This mortuary is not in our tradition before. In olden days, I can remember in 1980s, 1990, if somebody died, you will bury the person after 2 days. You will keep the person in the house and wait before 2 days, that person will not wake up. You will bury that person. Because I come from a Ebonyi state in a house. During that time, before you hear that somebody is dead, that person will be around 100 years, 100 and something years. But now, you see how people are dying every day. People are dying on a daily basis. And if you go around all these places, they are building all this mortuary. Accident is happening on that road every day. Every day, accident is happening. Our people need to go back to our roots so that we can know what we are doing. If you become a Christianity, can you hear me? Okay. Now we need to go back to our roots. Anybody that is not happy with the truth, you are preaching. I hope we need to go back to our roots so that we can restore Biafra. There is no way we can leave our tradition and pursuing Biafra. So we have to go back to our roots and bring all those things that our forefathers keep, those beautiful things that they keep before, so that we can restore Biafra in truth and every honesty. Thank you very much, Mazi. God bless you.
Thank you, my brother. Our people must remain focused. Getting this freedom, there is a lot to do. In fact, the work never starts. The work never starts. The earlier we know it, the better. But we are going home. I'll be back in a minute.
My people, see my baby, my dear son.